Shiur white. Shiur white, before the war, was known to be a straight-up Mechal Shem Shemayim. It was Mechal Shabbos, a real Jew hater. You know, he was a Jew. And the Rebbe said, if I go to him, suicide, on the spot. He said, Rebbe, please, you have to go. It's so good for you. He said, fine, you know, that's what has to be, what has to be. And he goes over to Shiur white and says, I don't know if you know me, but before the war, I was called Shiur white. Yeah, I know you are. The Rebbe says, well, if you could see them in mind myself, he wants to know if you'd be able to change your working cell to be able to keep the laws of this holy day. Shiur white says, no, Rebbe, I can't be shown right now. But I like your chutzpah. See what I can do. Nothing I'll do that tonight. It's too late. I'll directly tomorrow. Next day, Shiur white, along with the Rebbe, are put in a cottage, and their job was, he organized one that they were supposed to clean the windows, and he gave them rags without any of the, you know, the spray or anything like that, so there was no sewer, and they were supposed to wash before, and they were scrubbing it down, all very nice and good. And throughout the time, the rabbis and the team were trying, you know, to remember the prayers of the day and say them together. Exactly 12 o'clock noon, the door burst open, and in walked two SS officers in full gear, a tray full of food that no one in the Holocaust ever saw. I thought, like, chicken, steak, like, the nicest food, like, I couldn't imagine. And they had big smiles on their face and they said, Jews, today's your lucky day. Pig out! And nobody moves. And they turned to Shiur white and they said, make these dogs eat right now. Shiur white, some of you know this officer. Today is Yom Kippur. Jews don't eat. You understand that if they don't eat, we're going to kill them all, and you. So it's Yom Kippur today, Jews don't eat on Yom Kippur. Father revolver, hold it to his head. Shiur white, if he's looking juicy right now, we're going to kill you. One more time, he looks up his head and says, today is Yom Kippur. Shot him on the spot. The guy who his whole life, he lived as a tremendous hater. That spark in the serious Kaddish finally realized what he was living for at that precise moment. And he prepared to die for it. Like so many of our grandfathers and grandmothers, great grandparents said. That's what I want to be when